Right, this coming week. So he decided to come earlier to Malaysia, and he told Vincent and Stephen Chin, "Brother, I'm coming earlier, partly for my holiday, but also tell me how I can be used by God."
然后呢，Brian呢，他在还没来之前呢，他就请教了这个我们的Vincent和Stephen弟兄，他说我在找一个礼拜会来到马来西亚，想请问一下，我可以为你们做些什么吗？
So Stephen called me and told me about it. I said, "Brother, we need to get this man down to JB."
那么Stephen打电话给我了，我就想说，好啊，那么我们必须请这一个神的仆人来为我们传道。Okay,
and today I spent some time having lunch with Brad and Ginny, and I really appreciate their faith and their love for God.
我今天下午在跟他们花时间的时候呢，发现说他们是多么属神的，然后能够跟他们在一起，真的是很棒。Okay,
Brad's been a Christian for 35 years.
哦，那么Brad呢？他成为基督徒已经35年了。
He's still very young.
非常的年轻，对不对？
Gangs, look how energetic he is. Traveling all over the world, preaching the word. And not only that, he began his relationship with the Malaysian churches about 10 years ago. At that time, he was leading the Pittsburgh church. And the Pittsburgh church was supporting, the gang supporting financially, helping out with some of the Malaysian churches with mission support.
在当时候呢，就是Pittsburgh Church呢是帮助了资助了马来西亚的某一些教会。
Okay, so we appreciate not only his energy but his U.S. dollars, not his but the church U.S.
dollars.那我们当然呢，不但只能够感激着他的对我们的爱心，甚至更感激的是他的美元呐。Amen,
very powerful, right?
很强大，对吗？
Okay, and then but you know what the thing I appreciate about him is he decided we're not just gonna support financially, but we want to build a friendship with the churches in Malaysia.
那么很感激的Brad的心意就是说他不单是资助我们，但是更盼望跟我们能够建立一个友情。So
he's been traveling to Malaysia for I think four times already, right? Just to spend time with the Malaysian churches. Okay, it's a long flight. It's a big sacrifice. Because they live in the east coast of Malaysia, US. I think it's pretty.
他其实是在美国的东部住的
20 over hours flight, right?
他差不多只20多个小时。
Okay, it's not easy, it's like double the time we take our bus to Ipoh.
我们去怡保的时间你要双倍。
You know, that's the kind of heart that they have to serve people.
这就是他们的心意了，他们要服侍人的那个心。
And then he says, not only that, I want to come and visit Malaysia more often, maybe every year.
Wow. 那么我是就是说他希望呢，能够每年都能够来拜访马来西亚教会。
And maybe, you know, in the future, they might decide to be full-time missionary in, well, who knows where, but we pray in Malaysia, you know.
他们有一天呢，他们能够就是出去传道。那么你那里懂是在哪里？应该在马来西亚啦。Right, we have to plant a dream in his heart.
我们把那个种子种在他们心里面。Okay, but I really appreciate their love for people. You know.
Okay.
And that's why you know I'm sure when he preached the word to us today, it will come from his heart, his sincerity, and it will really help us all to grow.
我觉得今天他传道呢，肯定是发自他内心的，肯定能够帮助大家的成长。
So let's make sure we, as he teach, make sure we take notes and listen carefully and think about how it will impact you, how you can grow from, you know, the lesson that's going to give.
他在传道的时候，希望大家能够做到就是 写笔记，甚至想一想，他如何能够帮助你个人生命去成长。Okay,
so communion will take communion after his lesson.
我们的圣餐是在他的传道过后。So
right now I'm going to invite Brad. Let's give him a hand.
Force of habit.
因为已经是习惯了，你知道吗？
Thank you so much for your kind words.
感谢你对我的那个美言。
I think I'm pretty sure that Jeannie and I benefit more from our relationship with you than you do with us.
其实呢，今天我在想着，其实我跟你们的关系反而是你们帮的我跟 Jeannie 更多。
I'm very sure.
我完全明白。
Yeah, one of the reasons that we made a special trip this time was my wife and I have had some challenges, you know, over the last few years, just ministry kinds of challenges, and some of our closest friends are Vincent and Jane.
那么我们这次早一点来的原因是因为呢，我们在于带领上，我们呢有一些挣扎，然后我们特别是来这边呢，是因为我们想遇见我们的好朋友Vincent和Jane。And
so we spent some time with them last evening having dinner, and honestly getting some discipling, you know. And so Vincent and Jane are very, very dear to us and trusted friends, and you're lucky to have them.
那么Vincent和Jane呢，对我们来说呢是。 是我们非常信任的一个朋友，那么你们呢，真的是需要感恩，有他们在带领我们。And
you know, we've had the chance to spend some time together also for lunch today, and very, very much appreciate just your hearts for the Malaysian churches and the ways that you guys serve here, you know. So Tech and Patrice, you're also very, very fortunate to have a couple with that level of maturity that's committed to building small churches. That's not typical.
那么甚至呢，今天下午呢，我跟了Tech Patrice 在花一时间，然后感恩着他们对于马来西亚小教会想帮助马来西亚小教会去成长，当然今天我们有他们呢，我们应该需要感恩。So
do you like stories?
Yeah.
你们喜欢听故事吗？
Every parable tells a story.
每一个比喻呢，都讲一个故事。
And every parable answers a question.
然后每一个比喻呢，都回答生命的一个问题。
So part of understanding the parables is understanding the question.
当我们要去明白这个比喻的时候呢，我们先明白那个问题是什么。
So this morning I want to share with you one of my favorite parables, Matthew 20.
今天我想要跟大家分享马太福音20章我最喜欢的一个比喻。
But before we do that, we need to begin in Matthew chapter 19.
在没开始之前，我们先念马太福音19,
which is where we find the question that this parable strives to answer.
那也就是找到呢这个问题的来源.
So Matthew chapter 19, verse 24.
在马太福音19章第24节.
So what's just happened is Jesus has spent time with the rich young ruler.
然后在那时候呢，耶稣跟了一个有钱人，花了一些时间。
And of course, the disciples have witnessed this interaction, and they're a little bit confused.
当他们看见了耶稣跟这个人的交流，他的门徒有一点混乱。
And of course, you probably are familiar with the story that the rich young ruler comes to Jesus, and he asks this singular question, "How do I inherit eternal life?"
当然，你可能会听过这个故事，就是说这个。 年轻有钱人呢，来到耶稣问耶稣说，我要怎样能够去天国？
And so Jesus has this conversation with him, and Peter is not happy with the answer.
那么当看见了这耶稣在跟他交谈过后呢，彼得却不高兴耶稣的答案。
Have you ever asked God a question and you didn't like the answer?
你曾经有试过吗？你跟神问了个问题，当神回答你的时候，你不喜欢那个答案。
Or asked your disciple or a friend in the church for some advice and you didn't like the answer.
或者是你问了一些意见，你跟同跟你的朋友跟你的辅导人，他回答你，你不喜欢。
This happens to us from time to time.
我们常常会面对的。
So we're going to pick this story up in verse 24. So they've been talking with the rich young ruler, and the verse says this. Again, I tell you, it is easier for a camel to go through the eye of a needle than for a rich man to enter the kingdom of God.
Okay, 我又告诉你，骆驼穿过针的眼，比财主进上帝的国还容易呢。
When the disciples heard this, they were greatly astonished and asked, Who then can be saved?
那么门徒听见这话就稀奇的说，他说，这样谁可以得救呢？
Jesus looked at them and said, With man this is impossible, but with God all things are possible. And so Peter answered him, Well, we've left everything to follow you. What will there be for us? By which he means me.
那么耶稣就看着他们说，他说这人这是不可能的，但是在神呢，凡事都能。彼得就对他说，他说看啊，我已经撇下所有的跟从你，将来我要得什么呢？
Jesus said to them, I tell you the truth. At the renewal of all things, when the Son of Man sits on his glorious throne, you who have followed me will also sit on 12 thrones, judging the 12 tribes of Israel. And everyone who has left houses or brothers or sisters or father or mother or children or fields for my sake will receive 100 times as much and will inherit eternal life. But many who are first will be last, and the last will be first. And so the question Peter is asking is, if I follow Jesus, is it worth it? What's in it for me?
那彼得跟他问说，他问的问题是值得吗？跟从耶稣真的值得吗？
He's just watched the rich young ruler, who is moral, wealthy, and wants to know God, be denied entrance to the kingdom of heaven, and he's confused.
因为呢，他刚刚才看见了这个有钱人，他不但是有钱，他甚至道德相当高了，都被拒绝不能上天国，他就开始有点疑惑了。他说：“这样怎么做？”
Back in those days, similar to today, the belief about spiritual things went something like this.
而在当年，如果是要想关于到对某一些事情有信念，是这样的。
If I'm a good person.And I have a lot of wealth, God must approve of my lifestyle.
那么如果呢，我呢，我在当年呢是有钱，那么肯定是因为神他祝福我的生命。
And so he looks at the rich young ruler who's lived a moral life and who has a lot of money, and he walks away sad, and Peter is confused, and so he asks this question of Jesus, Hey, if I give up everything, what am I going to get?
那么彼得他就想，他说，这个人他有钱，有道德观念，他都，不能够，到达这个要求。这样子，我如果是给了所有，这样我可以得什么呢？
And Jesus answers the question with this parable in Matthew chapter 20.
那么，耶稣呢，他就用马太福音第二十章来回答了。
This parable.Is the answer to the question, is it worth it to follow Jesus? Is it worth it to follow Jesus?
所以呢，这节经文呢，其实就在回答到底是不是值得跟从耶稣的。
I'm going to read 16 verses.
Come on.
Read the whole parable. For the kingdom of heaven is like a landowner who went out early in the morning to hire men to work in his vineyard.He agreed to pay them a denarius for the day, and he sent them out into his vineyard.
那么第一节，因为天国好像家主清早去雇人进他的葡萄园做工，和工人奖定一天一银子。
About the third hour, 9 a.m., he went out and saw other men standing around in the marketplace doing nothing, and so he told them, "You also go and work in my vineyard." And I will pay you whatever is right. So they went. He went out again about the sixth hour, noon, and about the ninth hour, 3 p.m., and he did the same thing. At about the 11th hour, 5 p.m., he went out and found still others standing around doing nothing. And so he asked them, why have you been standing here all day long doing nothing?
那么几出出去看见世上还有闲站的人呢，就对他们说：“哎，你们也进葡萄园去做当给的，我被给他们，他们也进去了。”越在午正和申出又出去，也是这样行。越到西出出去看见还有人站在那里，就问他们说：“你们为什么整天在这里站着呢？” 他们说因为没有人来雇我，他说你们也进葡萄园去，到了晚上。
Because nobody has hired us, they answered. So he said to them, you also go and work in my vineyard. So when evening came, the owner of the vineyard said to his foreman, call the workers and pay them their wages, beginning with the last ones hired and going on to the first. So the workers who were hired at the 11th hour came, and each received a denarius. So those came who were hired first, they expected to receive more. But each of them also received one denarius. When they received it, they began to grumble against the landowner. These men who were hired last worked only 1 hour, and you've made them equal to us who have borne the burden of the work and the heat of the day.
Oh no. OK, 到了晚上，原主对管事说，叫工人都来给他们工钱，从后来的起到先来的为止。越在称书雇的人来了，个人得了一两银子，以致那先雇的来了，他们必。 必以为要得要多得，谁知也是各得一钱。他们得了，就埋怨家主说：“我整天劳苦受热，那后来的只做了一个小时，你竟叫他们和我们一样吗？”家主回答其中一个人说
：“But Jesus, the master answered them, friend, I am not being unfair to you. Didn't you agree to work for a denarius? Take your pay and go. I want to give the man who was hired last.” The same as I gave to you? Or are you envious because I am generous? So the last will be first, and the first will be last.
那么家主就回答其中一个人说，他说，朋友，我并不亏待你，你以为我奖金的不是一两银子吗？拿你的钱走吧，我给那后来的和你一样，这是我愿意的，我的东西难道不？
I want to talk a little bit about the background of this parable.
我想跟大家解释一下它的背景。
Back in those days, people didn't have careers, they had jobs.
在以前呢，他们并没所谓的就是事业，他们只有做工罢了。
Just about everybody worked for a daily wage. They got up, they went to work. If they didn't get sick and they didn't get injured, they came home with money day after day.
那么这些人呢，他们以前呢，就是说他们每天就是起身的过后呢，每天就是如果没有生病的话，就是需要去做工，一天做工得到一天的工钱回来，每天都重复。So
here you have a story of a rich person who has property, a vineyard. He's probably a vintner. He makes wine for a living.
那么这时候呢，讲到有个财主，他有这个葡萄园，他可能是酿酒的。And
it seems like perhaps it's harvest season. And so we know he has employees, but it's so busy, and his vineyard is so fruitful, he needs to hire up extra bodies. So he goes down to the marketplace early in the morning, which was very typical.
那这时候呢，就是说，可能他的就是生意很好，然后而且生产很多，那么因为人手不够呢，他需要早早就去到市场上去找额外的工人。
So I want you to picture this. It's early in the morning. Before dawn, and this man walks through the marketplace, who are the people that will be standing out that early looking for work? What are they like?
你想象一下，这个主人呢，他早早很早就去到市场上 然后去看哪一些是很早就起身找工作的。
And then think about as the day goes on, and it gets later and later in the day, how does the quality of the workforce in the marketplace change?
然后之后呢，他就在那边待了整天，他就在看着市场上的工人整个是不是在改变呢？
There's a relationship between the quality of the work and the age and energy of the workforce as the day goes on. There's an inverse relationship. Early in the morning, you have the young, the desperate, those who are healthy and without a family to keep them at home.
在其实呢，整个过程呢，他的早上到中午的这个时间呢，工人的那些品质呢，其实是有不同的。早上可能是那些比较年轻的，有精神的，他们去找工作。
So think about perhaps someone who's in construction or building something, and they go to a place to find laborers for the day, and they go early in the morning. Who's there early in the morning? The youngest, those who didn't stay up all night partying, and those who don't have any diapers to change that morning.
那么，在那些找工作的呢，肯定就是早上早早的是哪一些？是那些年轻的，那些不需要熬夜去换婴孩的尿片的，他们在那边找工作。So
as the day goes along, now it's 12, 1 p.m., 2 p.m., and the people that have straggled out to the marketplace at that point are older, perhaps they're sick, perhaps they've lost an eye. Something has happened that's prevented them from being able to be out there early. And so as the master comes back again and again and again, what he's going to get from those people decreases as the hours go along.
那么这个主人呢，在下午一点、两点的那个时候呢，他去找，可能那时候出来的人是什么呢？可能是比较年长的，可能是有生病的。
This is a culture, and this is a man, this is an employer who values strength, energy, fitness, and youth. His business rewards production.
对于这个主人来讲，讲真的，他的工作的要求真的需要你很健康，你很强壮，然后你真的是有这个能力来去，因为他的工作的性质是这样。Who
would go into the busiest season in their company and hire the weakest, least fit people? Who would do that?
当然，你想一下，有谁会这么做？就是当你在最忙碌的时候。 你去请一个根本是不能够符合标准的工人去做工呢？
I'll tell you who would do that.
我告诉你谁会这么做。
Someone who values people over profit.
哪一些呢？是那一个呢？重视人多过重视盈利的。
Each of these people, they went to the marketplace early in the morning. Because if they didn't go there, they wouldn't work that day. They went seeking sustenance.
那么每一个人去到市场上找工作呢，他有一个目的，就是他寻求一个寄托。They
just wanted their daily bread.
他们每一天都需要有一个每一天的食物。They
were day laborers, and if they missed this opportunity, their family likely went without food that night.
那么，如果是他当天没有工作的话，很可能一家人就没饭吃了。These
are desperate men.
这些人都很积极的。Desperate
men in need of a handout.
那么他肯定很需要。Seeking
sustenance from the rich.
那么我们需要从一个富裕里面去寻找。How
does it feel to need to borrow money?
你如果今天要跟别人借钱的感受是什么呢？
Fathers, how does it feel to worry whether you can support your children?
或者是父亲，你忧虑没法子能够帮助，就是给足够的钱养活你的家人的感受又如何？
Students, how does it feel when tuition is coming due and you don't have the money.
或者是说你想要做的事情你根本都没有钱去做。
These people came out because they had no choice, they had no option.
那么这些人呢，他们出来的原因是因为他们也没其他的选择了。They
came out of obligation, not necessarily desire.
那么这些出来的人呢，他们是无法选择才出来的。They
came because if they didn't work that day, they may not get an offer that week or even in the weeks that followed. They may go hungry for a long time.
他们很害怕，若当天没做工，他们可能之后也不被受邀请，就是录取。
So the later in the day, perhaps some of them came just out of curiosity.
那么在当天可能就有一些人就很好奇的来到市场上。
As the day went on, all the young people understood that the best jobs had already been given away. So why did they keep going?
那么在想到说，这些人他们在想，其实好的工作早已经被人拿走了，早上对不对？ 可是为什么还是有人继续不断出来呢？
So the master has a lot of power, doesn't he?
所以换句话说，这个主人其实他有很多的能力，对不对？
He has the power to give them bread or to give them significance and dignity.
那么他可能就是说可以给他们每天的足够吃的，但是也给他们一个就是一个尊严。
If you've ever had to borrow money from someone, you know that there's two ways they can give it to you.
你如果要跟一个人借钱的话，他其实有两种方式可以给你钱。
They can give it to you in a generous way, or they can give it to you with strings attached.
Phrase. 那么他其实可以给你，就是说很慷慨的给你，也或者是他是有目的性的。
This is a master that has no strings attached.
但是呢，这个主人呢，却完全没有目的的。This
is a master that understands that just getting out of bed and dragging yourself down to the marketplace at 3 in the afternoon is a hugely undignified act, and they don't really want to do it.
那么在中午再出来的时候的那些。
This is a master who understands how difficult it is for somebody to go all the way down to the marketplace at 3 o'clock in the afternoon and how humiliating that could be.
Okay,其实这个主人他其实知道，这些中午出来的人呢，他们其实是你要中午出来祈求早吃呢，是已经是很需要谦卑，很要有尊严的，更要讨吃这样子的心态。
Because remember, the marketplace is a public place. And so everybody that's standing around in the marketplace, they're not just interacting with the master, but the whole village sees them in need. So to be in the marketplace that late in the day is to lose face, to lose honor.
那么你如果是在中午这样子出来早吃呢，其实是很丢脸的。And
the master understands this, and so he rewards their perseverance not with shame, but with dignity and work.
那么呢，这个主人呢，为了鼓励他们呢，给了他们不单是工作，甚至也给了他们尊严。
And this is, of course, because God is more interested in feeding the heart than he is in feeding our stomach.
那为什么呢？那是因为这也意味着神呢，他不单单是喂养你的肚子，而是最重要重视的是喂养你的心。This
is a master who cares more about the person than about the paycheck.
因为呢，这是一个关心人多过关心那个人得到的一个主人。
This is a master who already understands how humiliating it can be to be that needy, and he preserves our dignity and meets our need at the same time.
那么因为呢，这个主人呢，他真的明白到一个人要祈求呢，已经是他明白那种心 他还给这些人那个尊严。
Back in our text.
回到我们的经文上。
So you have this whole setup. All of this is the setup for the punchline.
那么整个这时候呢，我们听了整个过程。
So there's this long story and all of these characters and if you lived in this time, you're picturing what it would be like to be them. Maybe you've been that person and you're feeling this anxiety and all of a sudden, when it's time to get paid, something very different happens.
那么你想象，你如果是在当的时候，你在工作，你在工啊，在工人之一，那么这时候可以啊拿工钱了，然后突然间有一些事情啊发生了。
Let's read it again.
我们再看。
When evening came, verse 8.
这第八节,
when evening came, the owner of the vineyard said to his foreman, call in the workers and pay them their wages, but I want you to begin with the last ones hired and work backwards to the first. So what does this mean?
那么到了晚上，岩主就对管事说，他说，叫工人进来，说给他们工钱从后来的起，到先来的为止。 那是什么意思呢?
Think back to our marketplace demographic.
那我们再想到刚才之前的那个整个市场上早上晚上的那个找工作的情形。
So the people that were hired first are the younger, stronger, perhaps more ambitious, and they've been working all day long. And now it's the end of the day, and they watch these old, broken down, not very capable, not very effective people come in and make the same money that they make.
然后你想象这些早早就出来找工作的那些年轻人，然后他们看见什么呢？他们竟然看见这个主人给了那一些啊，没有比他们强壮，甚至可能又生病的那些啊比较年长的那些工人。
And they don't like it.
然后他们就不喜欢。
And so what it says in verse 10 is that as they're watching this happen, and they're watching those that have worked 1 hour or less make a day's wage, they begin to think to themselves, I got a good payday coming.
那么这些人怎么想呢？他就想了，当然他想说，这些生病的人，他们这时候也不能够像我强壮，而也能够得到一个银钱的话呢，那么我在想着，我应该会比他更多吧。
They begin to feel entitled to more.
然后他就在想着，他说，他想得到更多。
More than they were promised.
已经忘了他就是答应多少钱做工。
More than they had earned.
多过他们要应该应得的。
And surely more than they would have had there been no master.
也就是，sorry.
Surely more than they would have had there been no master.
如果是没有主人的话，根本一分钱都没有嘛。
Sorry about the third person teacher. Understand, right? That they came out with the promise of a day's wage, and in 8 hours they'd gone from needy to entitled. One day. I need, give me. One day.
那你可以想象这些人呢，他能够一天里面就改变了那种心。从一天，他本来他是需要去祈求的，到最后呢，变成说我应得的这样子。
How does this happen?
怎么会变成这样呢？
The same way it happens to us.
其实很多时候我们自己本身也会面对。
When we forget what God has given us, and we begin to look at what God has given other people.
因为当我们忘记了神给我们什么时候呢？我们开始去注意到，神给了其他人什么祝福。
Everybody felt great about getting hired until they saw someone else getting paid.
我们每个人呢都会就都会注意到这点，除非我们看见别人得到比自己好像多的时候。
Just like the Apostle Peter felt great about the rich young ruler until he realized that he didn't get paid.
就好像彼得一样啊, 但彼得他以为他自己得了更多，可是当他看见了这个有道德的这个有钱人，他都得不到什么，他开始有感觉了。
This is a parable that tells us what God values.
其实这段经文呢，很清楚的在告诉了我们神的价值是什么。
And it's not hard labor.
那肯定不是努力的工作啊。
It's saying yes to the invitation.
而是呢，答应他的就是他的邀请。
It's saying I need help, and the master will give it.
也就是换句话说呢，你是承认你需要帮助，然后你相信主人可以施给。
It's putting my pride and my dignity aside and saying I have a need that only the master can meet.
也就是换句话说呢，我们需要把我们自己的尊严放在一边，然后跟这个主人说，祈求说，我真的需要帮助。
So here's an interesting question.
这是一个很有趣的问题哦。
Why does the master?Make them watch the other people get paid.
那这为什么这个主人呢需要让这些人看住他给这些人工资呢？
He could have paid them one at a time. Why this big demonstration?
这个主人他为什么他本来他可以私下给他们工资，他又为什么在这么多众人面前去给工资呢？
I think there's two very simple reasons.
两个主要的原因。
When we watch what God does for other people, our own gratitude is tested.
因为当我们看见神他如何对人的时候呢，我们感恩的心受到考验的。
And we get to watch God bless people that we perhaps wouldn't bless, and we learn about His character.
然后呢，当我们再开始察觉到神的祝福的时候呢，我们就会回想一切。
These people had a front row seat to grace, front row seat on grace, and they got entitled instead.
而这些人呢，一开始呢，他们得到神第一手的祝福，可是却变得是理所当然的。对。
Imagine the nerve.
可是呢，你去想到那个。紧张
the ego
那个你的那个尊你的尊严
Where were all of these people 9 hours earlier? In the same bread line, same place.
那么这些人呢？他们早他们就在那个地方等了。
How quickly we forget our need.
你知道吗？我们是多快忘记神曾经祝福我们吗
？They went from need to grace to entitlement in one day.
他们呢，其实呢，从就是他们的需要，变得他们呢，得到神的恩典过后呢，可是最后呢，却又转变成为理所当然。
And the master is overwhelmed.Flabbergasted. I don't think there's a good word in Chinese for that. I can't believe it. Y'all understand that, right?
Yeah.
What?
那么这个主人呢、啊？他你知道吗？他的反应是，他真的无法想象这些人怎么这么快就变了。
Let me paraphrase.
Yeah.
Fair.What do you mean fair? You were broke, naked, and starving at 7 a.m.
你在跟我谈，你在跟我谈公平吗？你知你早上你根本是没得吃吗
？Are you envious at my generosity? Isn't that the same generosity that just paid you?
那么你在讲说。你在怀疑着我的埋怨我的这个慷慨吗？难道不是这个慷慨给了你赐，给了你工钱吗
？Brothers and sisters, you are all overpaid by the grace of God. Overcompensated, overpaid.
其实弟兄姐妹，你知道吗？今天我们的生命是神的恩典大大的祝福的。
All of us have gotten much more than we deserve. In fact, all that we need
而我们每个人呢，其实都得到过于我们所需要的了。
But the trick with that is this. We have to keep our eyes on what God has given us and stop comparing our lives to what God has given others. When we take our eyes off of God and begin to look at each other, we lose our gratitude for the grace of God.
那我们需要做的应该是我们不可以停止不看着不、不, 不去看着神。如果我们做不做的时候呢，我们把眼睛从神那边移出来移开来看的时候，我们将只会看见我们周围、别人、神的祝福。
Where's my blessing? Where's my boyfriend? Where's my husband? How come my kids aren't better looking? How come my kids aren't smarter?
那么呢，你在看着 你的眼目离开神，而你看着周围的时候呢，你就开始比较了。你说，我的男朋友呢，我的丈夫呢，为什么我的孩子怎么长得不漂亮啊？为什么你就开始有很多的埋怨和比较
？But you're all very good looking.
当然呢，在这边呢，也要鼓励大家，其实你们其实都长得非常好看的。
That's called the backstroke in America. I'll just leave that one untranslated. Brothers and sisters, this is an amazing parable about what God cares about. And the answer is you are what God cares about. Not what you can do for God, but what God wants to do for you. That's what God cares about.
那么弟兄姐妹，神真正关心的是什么呢？真正关心的是你，而并不是你所做的东西，反而是他重视的是你们。
When we take our eyes off of God, and when we forget what we need, when we look at what God has done for others, we get ourselves in trouble.
那每当我们开始忘记了、神的祝福，我们把我们的眼目从神的身上而移走的时候，我们就问题来了。
So I want to close with a story.
我想要跟大家分享、在结束做一个、故事分享。
A story about someone who、came late to the party、
是讲到跟他、就是有一个人他、迟才来到、这个 party。
You know, I have,、it's true, I've been a Christian for 30 something, 35 years, a long time.
是的，我没有错，我参与基督35年，很长了。
And you know, sometimes、when we get older,As Christians, we、tend to forget、how great it is to be a Christian.
那特别是当我们成为基督徒久了呢，我们有时候会忘记我们的成为基督徒是真的是那么的棒的。
You know, we go through things. Things happen to us.
我们其实经历了一些事，而且我们的一些挣扎。
Some of the dreams maybe that we had as younger Christians, we see them go by the wayside. They don't all come true.
那也就是我们充满年幼基督徒的某一些梦想，然后并没有实现。
And even if they weren't things that God promised, sometimes there are things we hoped He would do in our lives. When those things don't happen, we can lose heart.
那特别是我们呢，盼望着神在我们生命里面的一些事情，可是呢，它没有发生的时候呢，我们有时候会心灰意冷。
And we find ourselves asking that very dangerous question that Peter asked: If I stay with this.What's in it for me?
那我们呢开始呢就会反问这个问题，我们就好像彼得问的问题这样子，如果我继续这样做下去，我得到什么？
There's a man in Montgomery County, Maryland, where I'm from.
那我是讲到是来到来自一个美国的一个城市。
His name is Neil Mall.
他的这个人名叫做 Neil Mall。
Neil is a 17-year persecutor of the church.
他呢，他是整天逼迫，他是17岁，然后就整天逼迫这个教会。
His daughter Rebecca became a Christian when she was 20. She's been a disciple 21 years.
然后呢，这个他的女儿就是在
21 years.
21岁的时候成为基督徒。
His wife became a Christian 17 years ago. Mary has been a Christian 17 years.
然后说他的太太在17年前成为一名基督徒。
Almost from the day his wife was baptized, he began to persecute her.
也就是这个这啊这这这个人呢，他在他的太太成基督徒过后，就开始继续的逼迫他啊逼逼迫的教会。
Three days ago, Neil turned 76.
在几天前Neil 他这这个人他已经76岁。
Three months ago, Neil was diagnosed with terminal kidney cancer.
在几个月前呢，他被诊断有了这个这个肾的癌症，末期癌症。
Two months ago, Neil started studying the Bible with me.
在两个月前呢，他 Neil 就跟我读圣经。
He was resistant.
他那时候一开始是非常的抗拒的。
He was a little unpleasant.
也非常的就是很不愿意。
He wasn't always very compliant.
他却不是那么喜欢遵守。
When he went to the nursing home and they put him on a lot of medicine, he was downright cranky.
那么，特别是当我们去这个抚养医院见他的时候呢，他下来见我的时候呢，都是脸臭臭的。
Cranky. But you know, I spent a lot of time with Neil, and we listened to bluegrass music, and we drank root beer.
然后我就跟Neil花了很多时间，然后一起听了豪气音乐，而且也喝root beer。
Not tiger beer, root beer. No alcohol in this beer. Root beer. Soda. A soda pop. Yeah. 100 plus or something like that. Okay. Just wanted to make sure that was... Oh, yeah, root beer. Okay. You know, and slowly, you know, Neil's mind and heart about the gospel began to change.
然后奇妙的是 ，Neil 的心呢开始在对福音有改变了。
And I got my hopes up a little bit.
然后那时候呢，我就对了这对这个有很抱了一些希望。
About 6 weeks ago, I visited him in the hospital, and I watched him take what would be his last steps.
在几个礼拜前呢，我去拜访他，其实他正在末期，而且快要死的边缘。
Because as the cancer moved from his kidneys down into his hips, he lost the use of his legs.
那么他的癌细胞呢已经转移去到他的脚，去到他臀部那边，然后他整个身体已经不能走。
I was with him when he got his last haircut a few weeks ago.
几个礼拜前也看了他把他的头剃光了头发。
Yeah. And I've been in his house over the last few weeks as he came home for the last time.
那么我去他家。他最后一次回家。
And about 4 days ago, right before we left for Malaysia, Neil and I had a very strong talk about the sin that was in his life and some of the things that had gone on in his marriage and with his family.
在我还没有来马来西亚前几天呢，我就跟Neil 在谈了他生命里的一些罪。
And that was a tough moment because Neil is an older man. He's not well. He's sick.And I was in his face. It was a strong conversation. Not easy for him.
Neil 呢，他这个时候呢，已经是病的很严重，而且又是你的长辈。可是呢，我在跟他在交流的时候呢，我真的是很认真的在跟他讲，就好像刚才就是 break 这样子。
Right in the middle of that conversation, he picked up his phone.
在跟他谈的当中呢，他突然间他拿起电话。
And I thought, oh, I've lost him.
我在想完了。
He called his wife, who was in the other end of the house, and said, "Honey, I need you to come in here. Some things need to change."
然后呢，他就是其实打电话，他打电话其实打给他太太，就是在隔壁罢了。然后他就跟他太太说，他说，你进来，我要跟你讲，有一些东西需要改变。
This is Neil yesterday.
这是 Neil 昨天。
Today Neil's your brother in Christ.
然后今天呢，他受洗成为基督徒。
Neil came late to the party. The 11th hour. Neil may not, he may not be alive when I get home in 3 weeks' time. There's a very good possibility he'll die before I get home.
Neil 这位弟兄啊，他虽然很迟的来到神的国度，而且也很有可能，当我回美国的时候，他可能就已经不在了。
Neil will probably never go to church, and he'll probably never go to a Bible talk.
那么 Neil 呢，他也很有可能他没有机会去教会，甚至参加一个圣经讨论会的机会都可能没有。
There's a really good chance he won't see his children become his grandchildren become Christians.
那么也很有可能是他也没有机会看见他的孙子们成为基督徒了。
It's pretty sure he'll never see his next birthday.
那么很肯定的一样就是他肯定活不过他下一次的生日。
You see, Neil came very, very late to the party. He came into the vineyard at the 11th hour.
他 Neil 呢，他虽然是很迟才来
，But God in His mercy will reward Neil the same way He rewards me and the same way He rewards you, because that's what grace is all about.
那么神呢，却充满着恩典，就好像他祝福你、祝福我一样子的，他也祝福了 Neil。
So here's what I want to leave you with today.
今天呢，我希望呢，能够给大家留下这一点。
Do you appreciate what God has given you?
你今天懂得感恩神所祝福你的生命吗？
Or have you become cynical or grumpy?
还是呢，已经变得常常的埋怨神的祝福呢？
Or ungrateful?Because maybe all of your dreams haven't come true.
还是呢，你变得完全不懂得感激感恩。为什么呢？因为你觉得神并没有祝福你所有的梦想。
You know, some of you have been Christians for a long time. Some of you have been Christians for a long time in a small church. I know about that.
我知道我们有很多已经成为基督徒很久了。我知道。
Don't you ever undervalue how much Christ has done for you and how valuable.Are to him. Don't you ever do that.
但是呢，我这次劝你们呢，绝对不要忘记了神在你生命里面的种种的祝福。
Regardless of your situation and regardless of your choices, God loves you just as much today as He ever did, and your reward is just as sure as it's ever been, whether you've been a Christian 5 minutes or 50 years.
不管是你成为基督徒五年啊，成为五分钟还是几十年。神呢的祝福呢，对你还是永远不变的。
So remember these two things. Number one, God loves you just the same as He loves everybody else. God's love for us has nothing to do with what I can do for Him or how much I can produce for Him.
那么今天呢，我们学了两点。第一点就是，神的爱呢，根本不在乎我们到底能够为他付出多少的。
And whether you became a Christian at 17.Or 77, all of you are completely and utterly overpaid by the grace of our great God.
那不管你是在十七岁还是在七十七岁成为基督徒呢，都不用紧。那神呢的恩典还是超越了你生命的一切。
Thank you for letting me share my friend Neil with you today.
Thank you.
We appreciate what Brad shared today.
我们很感激，就是 Brad 弟兄为我们的传道。
When I hear his message, I definitely, was very convicted.
我听了他的传道，我感觉到非常的扎心。
It's so easy to be ungrateful and to forget what God has blessed my life.
因为真的是那么容易，我们就会不懂得感恩，忘记了神所有的一切祝福。
You know, especially when we look around us, like what he says, again, when we look at other people, then we sometimes get jealous.
因为就好像他所说一样，我们当我们向周围这样看的时候呢，我们有时候起了这个嫉妒的心。
And we forget that God has given us so much.
Right.
那我们就忘了神他。祝福我们生命的一切。
The fact that we can wake up every morning, that's a gift from God.
Yeah.
因为你知道吗？我们每天都能够起身活着就已经是一种祝福了。
Okay, and teens, your parents, that's a gift from God, you know.
That's right.
那么青少年们，你们知道吗？你们的父母是神给你们的一个就是祝福来的。
Okay, no matter how they are like, you know, and I know sometimes parents can be a little bit strong or controlling, but they're still your parents.
他们呢不管是怎么样呢，就是有时候可能是就是控制你多一些，但是不管怎样还是存爱心的嘛，对不对？
Okay, husband.
Amen. Oh, 所以丈夫们。
Again, you know, don't just be grateful for your wife when you first get married.
所以呢，不要在你结婚的时候才懂得感恩，说神给你的这个祝福哈。
Okay, always be grateful for her, because she has been with you even when you are such a another thing, huh?
然后所以呢，你真的是要感激着就是她不管是在你的好的时候、不好的时候。他都能够跟你在一起。
Amen. And I'm really, I got convicted that God loves me so much as a person, and that He values me no matter what I've done in life, regardless who I am. Amen.
Amen. 所以我也觉得说我很感激说知道就是不管是什么情况之下呢，都要感谢着神给我的一切。
So right now we're going to be partaking the communion, the bread and the wine. So as you take the bread and wine, think about the sacrifice that Jesus has given you. Okay, and learn and say a prayer of gratefulness towards Him. And Carmen will lead us in a prayer in Chinese. Right.
弟兄姐妹来我们呢，低头祷告。谢谢天父，父神，谢谢你父啊！今天父，当我们在听着Brad 弟兄的传道的时候，我们学习到，我们知道我们需要感恩。我们知道我们的生命里面呢，我们其实是不配得的。我们的生命里面呢，我们根本就是充满着许多的挣扎、罪然后我们根本不明白生命的意义是什么。可是神，你借着你的爱，借着你从耶稣身上启示给我们的那个爱呢，也是在十字架上的爱，他牺牲生命的爱，他的就是这个今天我们在领用圣餐的时候，这饼代表着耶稣的身体，这酒代表着耶稣的血，为着我们的为着能够就是赎我们的生命，而让我们能够过得一个知道明白着我们的能够拥有一种祝福的生命，所以我们祈求神你能够帮助保守我们让我们能够心里充满着感谢，当我们在领用这饼的酒，这一切祷告是奉我们主耶稣基督圣名的祈求，阿门。